In Greek mythology, the fantastic creature known as the Lernaean Hydra was a multi-headed water monster. It was considered invincible, because for every chopped-off head, the Hydra would grow two heads. Therefore, Heracles had to fight really hard to finally kill it. However, in freshwater bodies, ponds, lakes, and rivers, lives a tiny, delicate, elongated organism called Hydra in honor of its mythological ancestor. The real Hydra is a tiny animal. Its length is about 2 centimeters. In their structure, Hydras are very simple. They have a columnar or trunk-like body covered with 2 layers of cells, the outer one and the inner one. The lower end of the body is closed. There is a foot, known as the basal disc. Gland cells in the basal disc secrete a sticky fluid that enables Hydras to cling to a surface. In the upper part of the body there is the mouth, through which the Hydra absorbs food and discharges waste. After eating, the mouth closes tightly. To eat again, the Hydra has to tear this organ open by muscle effort. There are also thin mobile tentacles located in the upper part of the body. The Hydra is a voracious predator. It spreads its long tentacles like nets and lies in wait until a prey gets close enough. At the moment when the victim touches the tentacles, the Hydra activates stinging cells and shoots out poison, which paralyzes the victim. Then the tentacles begin to twist and pull the food to the mouth. If the amount of food is small, the Hydra will simply eat it. If the portion is too large, for example a mosquito larva, Hydras are able to stretch their body wall considerably in order to digest prey more than twice their size. The Hydra has almost no enemies in water. If a fish attempts to nibble at it, it will instantly release it after getting stung in its oral cavity. As for humans, don't be afraid. The stinging cells of Hydras are too weak to hurt people. Hydras do not always cling to a surface, and they do occasionally move around. They have 3 distinct methods of movement. Number 1, by bending over and pulling the foot up. This is called looping. In the second case, the body bends over, so it is called somersaulting. There is another, much slower way to move about. Hydras can glide slowly on their foot. By muscle exertion, the Hydra moves forward while still attached to a surface. The Hydra reproduces in 2 ways depending on the season. In summer, Hydras reproduce asexually by budding. The buds form from the body wall and grow into miniature adults complete with a mouth and tentacles. Then they break away when mature. The second method is for autumn, when it gets colder. At this time of year, all Hydras die, but before their death, females have time to release eggs into the water. These eggs settle to the bottom of the lake or pond to await better conditions. The eggs assume a tough outer coating, and the embryos inside remain in a state of anabiosis. In spring, the egg's coating softens and a new Hydra emerges from it. By the way, Hydras are of the same type as jellyfish. A jellyfish has 3 life forms: an egg, a polyp, and an adult jellyfish. But the Hydra does not progress beyond the polyp phase. The Hydra has a remarkable regenerative ability. When it is cut in half, each half will regenerate and form into a small new Hydra. Cut it across, and it will regrow the upper part, complete with tentacles, and the lower one with a foot. This is what earned the Hydra its name from the mythical Lernaean Hydra, which grew its heads each time they were cut off. Even if you mince a Hydra, it will restore its body. These unusual features make the Hydra a creature that is almost impossible to kill. Do you know that they do not appear to die of old age or to age at all? Hydras are biologically immortal. This fact was proven in 1997 by a scientist named Daniel Martinez. He collected 60 Hydras and placed them in tiny test tubes for 4 years. After this time, the Hydras not only remained alive, but also looked as young as on the first day. 4 years may not seem so long, but there is a rule of nature that says the smaller a living being, the shorter its lifespan. While butterflies live for only a few weeks, blue whales live for almost 100 years. It appears that a hydra 2 centimeters in size should live for about a month and then die, but that doesn't happen. As we said before, being born from an egg in spring, hydras die only after 4 or 5 months, not due to old age, but due to the onset of unfavorable living conditions for them. If summer lasted for years or even decades, tiny hydras could live in water all this time. That is why, after many years of scientific research, the hydra was officially recognized as immortal. But what is the secret of its eternal youth? Let's look at a human. The development of an organism begins with just one cell. Then it divides and multiplies. As a result of numerous division cycles, all the human tissues and organs develop. However, with age, aging cells accumulate in the body, which do not die but no longer perform their functions either, and stop dividing to boot. This makes the body lose its ability to renew itself, and so it gradually ages. What happens to the hydra then? Its stem cells have a capacity to renew completely every month. This means that aging cells do not accumulate as in humans, but are replaced by new ones once a month. This is the secret of the hydra's eternal youth. And finally, I will say that the hydra is not only a mythological monster and a real tiny animal, but also the largest of the 88 modern constellations in the sky.